Welcome to the Coast to Coast podcast, brought to you by Play Picks and the Lines, coming to you from the West Coast. Josh Lander, joined by my guy Nate Weitzer on the East Coast, and we are looking at a pretty nice, robust Friday night slate here. In this one, we're taking a look at the Atlanta Hawks headed to LA to take on the Lakers, where most people are back for the Lakers. Got a lot of guys coming back for the Hawks. Make sure you are staying on playpicks.com and thelines.com, making sure you're checking out who's getting in and out of those lineups right up until game time. Nate does have his great article up on playpicks.com as well, with some best bets and player props. And make sure you are liked and subscribed to the page. You can check out those other couple of videos we have for you today, including those player props, which are hitting at a pretty nice rate so far in 2022. And as always, if you do still need a FanDuel or DraftKings account, head to fdpicks.com or dkpicks.com and find those listings in your area, such as what we've got for tonight. Nate, let's get into it.
Yeah, you said it's robust slate. I mean, seven games, but really most of them are quality games that you're going to want to tune into. Could say it's a ball night here on January the 7th. And we're talking about the Lakers here closing out the slate. They're minus 2.5 at the moment against the Hawks. We don't know if Trae Young's going to play. He missed their last game with a sore back. But we'll circle back to that one. We're looking at the six other games here. We've got Spurs with about five guys out in protocol now, plus 7 at the red hot Sixers. The Bucks are plus 3.5, and Giannis is expected to return after missing one game there. At the Nets, who are obviously going to be without Kyrie Irving after he made his debut on Wednesday, unless he, you know, decides to get vaccinated between now and game time. Timberwolves are minus 5 at Thunder. The Wizards are plus 6.5 at the Bulls. Kings plus 7 at the Nuggets. And the Cavs are minus 4.5 at the Blazers right now. So these Lakers, I feel like they were turning things around here. You know, winning 4 of their last 5 with a fantastic offensive rating, second best in the league during that span, slowing the pace a little bit so that they can get more quality shots. And Malik Monk has been a big key, really, to finding that floor spacing that they needed so much alongside Westbrook and LeBron. I mean, LeBron committing to taking more threes, and but Monk's ability to stretch the floor. He's averaging 21 points per game and hitting 45% of his triples for a 140 offensive rating during that 5-game stretch. That's clearly been key, but the headline here is that LeBron is going to be out for some revenge, just as he was last night against the Kings for whatever imperceptible slight they sent his way. He was roaring at their bench as he beat them. And the Hawks, the last time he played them, Solomon Hill rolled up on his ankle in March and ended his MVP campaign. Prior to that, the Lakers had won 3 straight against Atlanta. LeBron did whatever he wanted against this undersized Hawks team, 29 points per game and 11 assists per game over 4 meetings. And obviously, he's been crushing lately. Over his last 9, he's averaging 34.3 points per game. Over his last 6, he's hit at least 3 threes, you know, stretching the floor on his own. That hasn't necessarily led to wins for the Lakers, though, until recently, when, again, they've started to play with a little more control. Russ Westbrook jumping on that train, had a game without a turnover for the first time in years. Just being and they've got everybody back from protocol. It's you know, it's 2022. It's time to round the corner. We've seen this from LeBron teams in Cleveland. That he was able to, you know, slow roll it to that degree here with this Lakers team. It's been a little bit more desperate. But when the coach on the floor starts to figure out how to move the pieces around him to put everybody in the best chance for success, good things start to happen. And I think you look at a Hawks team that's just been dreadful on defense since getting Trae Young back, with or without him. I mean, they did fail to go over for the first time without him because their offense dipped when he was out against the Kings. But with their defensive numbers over their last 5 games, I have a hard time imagining they'll stop the Lakers often enough to stop this little streak that the Lake Show is going on. And I feel very good about a small 2-point spread here because Lakers have been winning straight up. I mean, as favorites, 16-11, including 4 straight wins as favorites. It's just that covering these big spreads that were placed at the beginning of the season, inflated by their reputation, they have not been able to do that. But I think they can certainly win this game.
Yeah, no, I think they should win this game. I think, you know, this comes down to LeBron, which is pretty much right now everything for the Lakers comes down to LeBron. As you mentioned, he's had some help on offense from Malik Monk. But, you know, this team in general is just still really bad on defense. They've managed to climb their way back to about 16th in offensive rating, at least over their last five, to your point, or defensive rating over their last five, to your point, so that, you know, they could at least get to that 4-1 mark, because their offensive rating still been so good, above 120, as you mentioned, second in the league in that time frame as well. And then we use the last five games because they've been predominantly healthy in that time frame. LeBron's been back to LeBron status, and you've really seen him just go, okay, I know I need to score. I need to get over 30 in order for us to win, because we're going to be giving up 110 points at least a game, which, you know, is around what they give up at home. Actually, it's pretty much similar score whether they're at home or on the road. They play a little faster on the road and are a little bit more efficient on offense at home, right? So there's a reason that they go over at home so much. 14-9 when they are at home to the over. The Hawks also go over a ton on the road, as they're incredibly bad on defense, fourth worst defensive rating specifically on the road. But as you mentioned, I mean, they've been bad on defense all season long, and that's really the reason that they're not back to the form that they were in the second part of last season and into the playoffs. So I think we both love LeBron. We both love him to carry this team to a victory by at least 2 points over a Hawks team that I think they are going to be getting some guys back, just because they, you know, a couple guys were cleared out of the COVID protocol. Bogey and John Collins specifically, they were cleared before their last game, but they still didn't play for one reason or another. So there's a likelihood they could play. Either way, I'm not scared of it, because they're going to need some time to get back into it. You know, as you know, Nate, having had COVID, not to call you out, just saying it's going around. People have it. It's tough to come back from. We've seen the remnants of it in a lot of guys this year. So I don't think you want to start betting on guys to be back to their peak form right when they get back. And Bogey and John Collins are as crucial to them winning this game as any other two guys on the floor, honestly, even including Trey and Clint Capella, because as we mentioned, Trey is a walking offense as soon as he gets on the floor, but he's also got back issues right now. That's why after scoring 56 points in a loss to the Blazers, he missed a game against the Kings, and he's coming back. He's day to day, probably could play. But at the same time, you know, what's that mean for them, for him specifically in terms of his health? And when Trey comes back on the floor, that leads me to like the over a little bit more. It's a little bit high at 225. I mean, we know how bad Trey's individual defensive rating is. He's not somebody that you look at as a stopper in any way, which is why you would also probably consider Malik Monk. I mean, he's been the second banana on this team, as you mentioned, over 21 points a game in that time frame as well. And also shooting 45% from three, which is why he's hit for about two player props in a row for us. But yeah, LeBron James to score, the Lakers to get theirs. And you know, as far as the total, I would feel more comfortable betting a team total like the Lakers to go over before I'd feel comfortable about that over, just because I don't know the state of Trae Young, and I don't know if he's going to have any offensive weapons to help them get there.
Yeah, I mean, that's the huge contingency right there, is if Trae Young is playing, then I love the over in this game. But if he's not, then I don't know, which is why I would just bet the Lakers over as it currently stands, because I would look at LeBron props. When you say out loud, you know, I need to score 30 for this team to win, well, you can bet that. You can get plus 220 to say LeBron will get 30 and they will win, which is pretty much what you would expect in this scenario, especially if he's as pissed off about the Solomon Hill injury as you know, anyone who backed him to win MVP that year is. And the Lakers are averaging exactly this total. You say it's high, but 225 is what they get at home, right? Yeah. And they've gone over in five of their last seven. They tend to go over when they play teams that like to play with any sort of pace. You know, Portland, Sacramento, Houston. These games have smashed an over of around 225 recently. The exceptions where they have gone under is Memphis, Minnesota, and Phoenix, teams that love to buckle down and play slower and play better defense there. So I do like the over. I think that maybe if you're concerned Trey's going to sit, you would tease it down with another game here. But I think that first and foremost, I would just keep it simple. With the Lakers here, the Hawks are giving it up both from 3-point line, giving up 43% from deep and 123 points per game over their last five. And they're giving it up inside the arc, giving up 56% on twos. You can really get whatever you want against this team. And that's what we have been saying about the Lakers all season. But as you said, they climbed up to average defense, and that's going to be good enough to outgun a Hawks team that's really going to need some time to gel now as they finally start to get their pieces back from this rolling COVID outbreak.
Yeah, and you hit the main point in terms of the total, which is Trae Young playing? Bottom line, is the man that we call a walking NBA offense going to be on the floor or not in any capacity with that back injury to carry that offense and you know, get that about not that, that not his usage rate is still close to 30. It's that, you know, time of possession that he's got the ball in his hands. That's still close to about 90% of the offense for the Hawks. So that tells you how important he is to that team. He's got the ball in his hands the entire time, whether he's distributing or running around and shooting. So that is all the time we have for this one. Make sure you are liked and subscribed to that page. Got a couple other videos for you on a really nice big Friday night slate for you, including that player props video we love to bring you every each and every weekday. And until we see you next, happy betting.